Tell me, have you ever heard the tale of the Cavalier Marriage of Blood? It begins as it ends, with a wedding. An aging king, long past his prime, took a young maiden, fair and wise, as his queen. She ushered in an age of peace and prosperity to his kingdom, and together they united the warring nations of the land to form a great commonwealth. That's right. I speak of none other than our Commonwealth of Cavalier. But I'm afraid the peace would not last. At least, not for some. A loyal knight took issue with his king conceding time and again to the whims of his young wife. The king, he argued, should be counseled by a body attuned to the will of his subjects, not by the desires of the queen. In the dark of night came the king's response. The armies of the neighboring lands all met in secret and massacred every member of the House of Blood, the knight's noble clan. No limb left unbroken, no throat left unopened. The House of Blood was drained from the land. How, you may ask, was such a mighty family wiped out in but a single night? An ambush. The younger of the Blood Brothers was traveling, on his way to see the king, in fact, to formally announce his marriage, when the soldiers fell upon them, and his blushing bride butchered by his side, the king's own daughter. A marriage of blood, indeed. Soon after, rumors began to spread. The bodies of the Blood Brothers and the young bride disappeared. Some say it was the king's men out to destroy, but some say the Bloods came back for revenge.
Awaken, my child, and take the gift I have bestowed upon you. Together, we will right the injustice you have suffered.
They will pay, every single one of them. Hell hath no fury like this bitch scorned.
Flesh of my flesh, blood of my blood, those with whom you choose to share my gift shall become your soldiers in undeath. Cease your suffering and restore balance to the land.
What is that thing?
House of Blood!